cities should be bicyclized for the environmental reasons, but also people like me who failed to attend their driving school for 2 years can stress-free ride around and transport their stuff on their bicycle trailers, because this is what I had to do past 2 years when I needed to transport something. And recently I made one and I'm gonna share it today with you how I've done it. So first you're gonna need a shopping cart. There are 2 ways to get them. First, you're gonna steal it, and second one, just write them an email. Hey, do you have some broken shopping carts? They always have some. For this project, I actually used a cart that we already had in our community repair space. We used it for members who wouldn't pay the membership fees. But luckily it was mostly empty, as it's really low, it's just 10 euros per year. So I didn't need to remove the bottom structure and the wheels. But this is what you need to do first. Next, I took a piece of plywood, placing it under the trolley. I found this CNC piece of plywood that used to be a table, I guess. But you can use normal plywood roughly in the same size. On top of that, I placed 2 bicycle forks on each side. In previous versions of the bicycle trailer, I experimented with all different kinds of forks. Pitchforks and also a couple of forks. But it started to demand some social benefits and stuff like that, so yeah, whatever. Bicycle forks tend to work the best. I placed the forks so they are exactly on the same level and marked lines where to cut the wood, as well as marking points for the bolts to come through later and where to cut the poles of the forks. I cut the plywood with jigsaw and a circular saw, and then the forks with an angle grinder. And then I drilled the holes I marked before. Once I had it all completed, I measured another piece of plywood that will add additional support for the whole frame. Marked it and cut. Next, I made the tongue. Apparently, this is how you called the bit that connects trailers to vehicles. In previous projects, I experimented with different kinds of tongues. Whatever. First, I took this piece of wood, positioned it into the center of the front of the trailer, and then clamped it so I could mark this little dot and also a line so it would later snug against the front side. I drilled that hole with a 12mm drill bit and then cut the line with a circular saw. And then I cut through the dot. Next, I took this tube that used to be table, I think, and cut it. Then bending it so it would snug nicely onto the pole, and then flattening the other end where the connector will come. Then I mark and drill holes onto it for bolts to come. The bolts will come. Then I organized romantic bath and spa for the forks. Anyways, so I would just scrub the dirt and grease off them. Then I dried them out and then sand them as well with the pole with really, really smooth sandpaper. After that, I painted them so it would fit the color of my soul, and I treated the wood nicely as well with this amazing finished product.
Tikkurilla unika kvalakka.
Twice. Then I spent some time with my old forks, and meanwhile all the stuff dried out. Then I assembled all the pieces on the floor and I sandwiched it all together. Next, I positioned the pole so the hole would sit on the frame of the cart. Then I bent this knobby so it would snug nicely with the pole and run a bolt through it. Then I connected the metal stick to the wooden pole. For the connector, I bent a bracket using my brute force and vice, and then fixed it onto the bicycle seat pole with a bolt, surprisingly, and then adding another one on which I put a carabiner. Then I took 2 links of this thick-ass chain and fixed them onto the connecting stick. Right, and also wheels. I attached wheels onto the trailer. Mm-hmm. Now some extra bling bling and we are ready to go. To sum it up, this amazing bicycle trailer, it's made up of mostly trash. You can put it together just with bolts and bolts and basic tools. It can carry really heavy load, and in addition, it's like, it's just so awkward, but girls, they just cannot hold themselves back when they see it. So it's a really cool chick magnet. So try to make it yourself and let me know how did it go. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to this YouTube channel. It's gonna make you feel so good. Bye.